That's USCIS classification, which we will go over it today. But before that, this is an example of textural classification. It's used by US Department of Agriculture, USDA, and again, it's a textural classification. What is an example? So if we have a soil, for example, soil A, and then we know that soil A is consisted of 30% sand, 40% silt, and 30% clay-sized particles, then you can find the description, the textural classification of soil A. So 40% silt, 30% sand, and 30% clay. So when you draw these three lines, you see that soil A is in this area, and the textural classification of soil A is clay loam. But textural classification doesn't provide the required information for engineering purposes. For engineering purposes, we use a different classification system. We use the system provided by USCIS. So that's the one that we will go over today. Unified Soil Classification System. It was developed by Arthur Casagrande, and it's what mainly used by engineers and government agencies. For highway design and construction, American Association of State Highway and Transportation Officials, AASHTO, is used. But for building construction, we usually use USCIS. And the third classification system is the system provided in the manual of OSHA, Occupational Safety and Health Administration. So these are three main examples used for construction, classification systems used for construction purposes. We will go over this one. Your homework is on this one. You have a quiz also today. And this is used for road construction, but we don't go over this one. We also look at what is provided in the technical manual of OSHA. So we will go over that tomorrow. So basically, we will use the results from sieve analysis and the results from Atterberg limits to describe our soil and to come up with a symbol for our soil. The symbol is consisted of two letters. The first letter is basically saying which type of particles we have in our materials. Is it gravel? Is our soil sample mainly gravel, sand, silt, or clay? So the first letter in our symbol is G or S or silt or clay. The first symbol is one of these four. And again, we use sieve analysis results to determine which one we have more in our soil sample. After we figure out if we have gravel, sand, or silt, then we need to describe that material. Oh, okay, it can be also organic or peat. Now, in order to So these are the first letters. One of these will be the first letter in our symbol, and one of these will be the second letter in our symbol. So we can have well graded or poorly graded, or we can have silty sand, for example, or clayey gravel. If we have silt or clay, then we can have low plasticity silt, or for example, high plasticity clay. Okay, that's USCS. We use a symbol which provides information for our soil. The first letter describes which type of particles we have more in our soil, if it's mostly gravel, sand, silt, or clay. And the second letter is used to describe that material. For example, if the soil symbol is shown as SW, it means that we have a well-graded sand. If we have a symbol that says GP, then it means we have a poorly graded gravel. What is ML? If the soil symbol is ML, means that we have silt with low plasticity. CL, clay with low plasticity. Again, this is USCS. So what we will go over today is to how can we find these symbols for our soil sample. There are two flowcharts. This is flowchart number one. Which you will use this slide when we have coarse grained soil. And this is flowchart number two, which you will use this when you have fine grained soil. We will go over each step in these charts. So let's look at flowchart number one first, which is chart for coarse grain soil. What we have here, soil to be classified. Then we have a step one. In a step one, you look at percentage passing from sieve number 200. In a step one, we want to determine if we have a coarse grained soil or a fine grained soil. If you remember, sieve number 200 has an opening of 0.075 millimeters. So if this is sieve number 200, whatever stays on top of sieve number 200 is coarse material, and whatever passes through sieve number 200 is fine, right? In USCS, we define fines as materials smaller than 0.075 millimeters or materials passing from 0.075 millimeters or passing from sieve number 200. So again, in a step one, in this chart and in this one, both of them, a step one is to determine if we have coarse grain soil or fine grain soil. So you look at percentage passing from number 200. If more than 50% is passing through number 200, means we have more than 50% fine material. Then we say we have a fine grain soil. If less than 50% passes through, which means that more than 50% is retained on number 200, more than 50% is staying on top of sieve number 200, means that more than 50% of the material is larger than 200. So we have more than 50% coarse. Then it will be coarse grain soil. So in a step one, look at percentage passing from number 200. If less than 50% finer than number 200 or less than 50% passes through sieve number 200, means that more than 50% is on top of sieve number 200 or we have a coarse grain soil. Then you move to the next step in this chart. But if when you look at percentage passing from number 200, you see equal or more than 50% is passing through number 200, means that more than half of your soil sample is fine. So then it will be fine grained soil. Then you need to go to flowchart number 2 in next slide. Everybody clear on step one? Step one, look at sieve number 200. Percentage passing from sieve number 200. If less than 50% passes through, we have a coarse grain soil. If equal or more than 50% passes through, we have a fine grain soil. Go to the next slide. Basically, we just want to see if more than half of the sample is coarse or fine. If more than 50% passes through sieve number 200 or is retained on sieve number 200. So right now we are using the results from sieve analysis. From step one, we determine that we have a coarse grain soil. So now we go to step two. Here is step two. And now we look at percentage passing from sieve number 4. Do you remember what do we call materials retained on top of sieve number 4, larger than sieve number 4? So if this is sieve number 4, Materials retain. On sieve number 4 is gravel. Passing through sieve number 4 is sand. So in a step 2, when we have a coarse grain material, we look at percentage passing from number 4 and we calculate what is called coarse fraction larger than number 4, which is basically what percentage of our coarse material is gravel or is larger than number 4. If more than 50%, if coarse fraction larger than number 4 is higher than 50, then we have gravel, and our first letter in the symbol is G. If the coarse fraction larger than number 4 is equal or less than 250, then the majority of our coarse material is sand, and the first letter in our symbol is S. That's a step 2. If you have sand, then you need to move to here. Now, a step 3, we need to describe our sand or gravel. So if we determine from a step 2 that the majority of our material is gravel, then you move to a step 3 here. This is a step 3. When we have gravel, this is a step 3 when we have sand. So again, we said that here, our first letter in the symbol is G. Now we need to describe that gravel. In a step 3, you again look at percentage passing from number 200. Percentage passing from number 200. If it's less than 5%, between 5 to 12%, or more than 12%. Same thing for sand. If it's less than 5%, between 5 to 12, or more than 12%. So percentage passing from 200 is actually the amount of fines that we have. If the amount of fines in our gravel is less than 5%, then we can ignore that we have fines in our coarse grain soil. So if we have less than 5%, the amount of fine is too low and we can ignore that. We just need to see if our coarse material, if our gravel is well graded or poorly graded. And if you remember, for gravel, if it's considered well graded, if coefficient of uniformity is equal or more higher than 4, and coefficient of curvature is between 1, 2, 3. If these two are satisfied, then we have well graded gravel. If they're not satisfied, then we have poorly graded gravel. Same thing for sand. If in our sand, the amount of fines is less than 5%, then we need to see if it's well-graded sand or poorly graded sand. So well-graded sand or poorly graded sand. That's when we have less than 5% fines. But what happens if we have more than 12% fines in our coarse material? then it's significant enough that for us, we need to know the type of finds that we have. Is it clay or silt? So here you need to use plasticity charts, which I will show it to you later. And also for sand, when we have more than 12%, you need to use plasticity charts to see if the finds that we have is silt or clay. Same here, we want to see if we have silt or clay. And then it's going to be GM, silty gravel, or clayey gravel. If it's in the hashed zone in the plasticity chart, then you have a dual symbol, GM, GC. Same thing here, SM or SC or SM dash SC. When you have a dual system, make sure that you place a dash between symbols. So we looked at less than 5%, more than 12%. There is a third option, the amount of fines in our gravel or sand is between 5 to 12%. Then you need to do both of these. So we need to determine if it's well graded or poorly graded, and if we have silt or clay, and then you have a dual system. Same thing here, well graded or poorly graded, and silt or clay. So we will go over this again, step by step, and then go over examples. But anybody has any questions? Again, this is the chart for when we determine from step one that we have a coarse grain material. That's a step one. In a step two, we need to determine if it's mainly gravel or sand. And then in a step three, we need to come up with letters to describe our gravel or sand. Now, let's look at the flowchart number two, which is for when from this step, you determine that more than 50% is passing through number 200, which means that we have a fine grained soil. So step one is similar to the previous slide. In step one, we look at percentage passing from number 200, but now we have more than 50% passing. So this is more than 50% percentage passing from number 200 is higher than, equal or higher than 50. And we say that we have a fine grain. When we have a fine grain soil in a step two, we look at liquid limit. If liquid limits less than 50, letter H. If liquid limit higher than 50, then letter, sorry, I put them the wrong. If it's higher than 50, then we have high plasticity. If it's lower than 50, then we have low plasticity, L. That's a step two. And then in a step three, You need to use plasticity chart. To find if it's silt or clay or silt. So this is a step two, this is a step one, and that's a step three. Okay, let's go over an example. You have the results from the sieve analysis. Can you tell me what is the answer to a step one? Do we have a coarse grain soil? This soil sample, is it a coarse grain soil or fine grain soil? Can you put your answers in the chat? Which one is this one? Is it a coarse grain soil or a fine grain soil? Or basically, which section of which flowchart do we need to use? Flowchart number one, which was for coarse grain, or flowchart number two? Anybody? Yes, that's correct. So, step one, we look at percentage passing from sieve number 200. So, in step one, we look at percentage passing from number 200. Percentage passing is 0.4%. We have 0.4%, which is less than 50%. So we have a coarse grain soil. Can you answer step two? So in step two, we need to calculate coarse flexion that is larger than number four. We basically need to find gravel percentage in coarse material. We want to see what percentage of our coarse material is gravel. In this example, gravel is 100% minus percentage passing from number four, and coarse is 100% minus percentage passing from number 200. So it's 100 minus 76.7 divided by 100 minus 0.4. This times 100. which gives us what? 100 minus 76.7. We have 23.6% gravel. And the total coarse material is 99.6. So 5%, 5.6% of our coarse is gravel, which is less than 50%. So we have cent. 23% is the percentage of gravel, right? So again, if we look here, gravel is 23%. Sand is between number 4 and number 200, right? 76.7 minus 0.4, so 76.3. And fines is 0.4%. Correct? So even by looking at these numbers, you can say that the soil is mainly consisted of sand. But what we calculate is 23, this number, divided by total coarse materials. In this example, it's not important because the amount of fine is very low, but sometimes these numbers are very close to each other. So you actually need to calculate the amount of gravel that we have in our coarse material. That is coarse fraction larger than number 4. Again, it's percentage of gravel divided by coarse material. It's not just percentage of gravel. It's how much gravel we have in our coarse section of the soil. Okay, so now we know that the first letter for this sample is sand. What do you need to look at? Which one? So now we are at a step three. This is a step three. Again, we need to look at percentage passing from number 200. So percentage passing from number 200 is 0.4%. So this is what we need to look at. 0.4 is less than 5%. We don't have CU and CC, so we cannot answer this question right now here. But if we had CU and CC, we could have determined what is the final answer for this soil sample. Let's say that again, here we had percentage passing from number 200 equals to 0.4%, which is less than 5%. So this is the section that we need to look at. If CU is 8 and CC is 1.7, then what is the final symbol for this soil? S dot. This one is satisfied. This one is also satisfied. So the final symbol is S. Any questions? Okay, this is an example of plasticity chart. And I'll show you another example and how we use plasticity chart. This is the A line, the blue line that you see here, A line, and the area with the orange color is the hatched area or hatched zone. Okay, so the next few slides are basically what we talked in the chart. It's for me personally, it's easier to use the chart, but you can also follow these slides. So in step one, we look at percentage passing from number 200. If less than 50% is finer than number 200, then so step one, let me just erase this and write it down again. Step one, we look at sieve number 200 and answer the question, if less than 50% passing from number 200, yes or no? Less than 50% passing from number 200. If the percentage passing from number 200 is less than 50 or no, then you determine if you have a coarse grained or fine grained soil. Then if the answer is coarse grained, that's a step two. Look at sieve number four and calculate percentage of gravel divided by percentage of coarse material. If that number is more than 50 or less than 50. If it's more than 50 and we have gravel, then this will be our step three. Again, you look at percentage passing from number 200. If it's less than 5%, then we have clean gravel, and we say if it's GW or GP, well graded or poorly graded. If it's more than 12, then we have gravels with fines. The percentage of fine is high enough so that we need to know if it's silt or clay, sorry. So it's going to be GM or GC. And if it's between 5 to 12, then it's the dual symbol. It's the same thing that I went over in the chart. In order to answer this question, well graded or poorly graded, you need to use this. CU. This is for gravel. And for gravel with fines, so this is for percentage passing from number 200, less than 5%, This is for percentage passing from number 200 more than 12%. If it's more than 12%, you need to see if it's silt or clay, and you need to use plasticity chart. For here, you need to use plasticity chart. And see if the point is above or below a line. Now, again, the same thing. Sieve number 200, we say coarse grain. If the answer is coarse grain, then you go to a step two and look at sieve number four, calculate percentage of gravel in coarse material. Now the answer is no. So then you have this. Now it's for sand. You may, again, you look at percentage passing from number 200. If it's less than 5%, you have clean sand, SW or SP. If it's more than 12%, then you have sands with fines, so SM or SC. And if it's between 5 to 12, you have the dual system. For clean sand, this is the table. So when percentage passing from number 200 is less than 5%, we say that we have clean sands, and you need to check these two requirements. But if percentage passing from number 200 is more than 12%, then you need to use plasticity chart. And if it's between 5 and 12, then you need to do both of these. You have a dual symbol. Okay, let's go over another example. We have the results from sieve analysis provided in the table and the results from Atterberg limits, which describes our soil as a non-plastic soil. So when you have a non-plastic material, you cannot do the Atterberg limits test. Instead, you just write down NP, which is for the material, for when the material is non-plastic. Can you provide the answer to a step one? Do we have a coarse grain soil or a fine grain soil? Which one is this one? Is this soil sample a coarse soil or a fine grain soil? So for this one, yes, that's correct. We look at percentage passing from sieve number 200, which is equal to 2%. So percentage of fines is 2%, which means that percentage of coarse material is 100 minus 2, 98%. So, step one, percentage passing from number 200 is equal to 2%. The answer is yes, 2% is less than 50%. So we have a coarse grained soil. When we have a coarse grained soil, in a step two, we need to see if it's gravel or sand. So we need to look at percentage passing from sieve number four. Percentage passing on sieve number four is 48%. Which gives us retained on number four as 100 minus 48. So again, we want to calculate how much gravel we have in our coarse material. This will be 100 minus percentage passing from number four. And this is 100 minus percentage passing from number 200. Divide them by each other and multiply by 100. This gives you 53%. So 53% of our coarse material is gravel, which is more than 50. So we have gravel. Any questions so far? So now we know that the first letter in our symbol is G. We need to describe our gravel. Step three, we look at percentage passing from number 200, which was 2%, which is less than 5%. So it's either well-graded gravel or poorly graded gravel. For gravel, this is the table for gravel. We need a CU higher than equal or higher than 4 and a CC between 1 to 3. So we need to make the grain size distribution curve. Find D60, D30, and D10. And we need to calculate coefficient of uniformity and coefficient of curvature. D60 divided by D10. This one is D30 to the power of 2 divided by D60 times D10. So when you do the calculation, CU is 63.3 and CC is 2.8. So both of these two are satisfied. And the final answer to this example is GW or well-graded gravel. Any questions on this example? Okay. Let's go over another example, and I give you a few minutes, like 1 or 2 minutes. Read the question, try to come up with the symbol for this question, or at least the answer to step one and step two. So what is the answer to step one? Is this a coarse grain material or fine grain? Anybody try to answer this question? So in a step one, we look at percentage passing from number 200, which is equal to 15.2%, which is again less than 50%. So we have a coarse grain soil. Fine grained is when you have more than 50 here, 50. As long as it's less than 50, it's coarse grain material. So we have coarse grain soil. So when we have coarse grain in a step two, you need to see if it's gravel or sand. So now we need to calculate percentage of gravel and divide it by percentage of coarse material. This is how much gravel we have. 100 minus percentage passing from number 4. So this is equal to 100 minus percentage passing from number 4, divided by 100 minus percentage passing from number 200 times 100. The answer is 27. 27% of our course material is gravel, which is less than 50. So here we have sand. Then in step three, we again look at percentage passing from number 200, which was 15.2%, which is more than 12. So we have sand with fines. So it's either SM or SC. And in order to find that, we need to use plasticity chart. This is plasticity chart. So for sand, we need to see, we need to determine if the type of fines that we have in our sand is mostly silt or clay. In order to do that, you need to check this table. It's M if plasticity index is less than 4 or plots below A line. It will be C if plasticity index is higher than 7 and our data point plots on or above A line. So if you look at the plasticity chart, we have liquid limit versus plasticity index. Pay attention that we have OR here and here. So we have liquid limit 30%. Plastic limit 12, you can calculate PI or plasticity index as LL minus PL, which gives us 18. So our point, the blue line is the A line, this is above A line. This one is satisfied. And PI is higher than 7. So that one is also satisfied. The final answer is clay A sand. Okay, any questions? So that's how we use plasticity chart. Whenever we have silt or clay, or the amount of fine is significant enough that we need to know if it's silt or clay, then we need to use the plasticity chart. So the examples that we went over were all coarse grained soil. Now let's go over fine grained materials. Characteristics of fine soils. Silt is very similar to sand and gravel, It's just that the particle size is smaller. It is formed due to mechanical weathering. Clay, on the other hand, is formed due to chemical weathering process, and it has plasticity. Okay, so the mineral represent chemical changes that have resulted from decomposition and alteration of the original rock minerals. When more than one soil type is present, the major constituents dominates the description. Presence of fine-grained soil dominates behavior of the soil if the amount exceeds one-third of the total soil. Organic material can greatly decrease the strength of soil. So this was the chart for when from step one, we determine that we have a fine grain soil percentage passing from number 200 was more than or equal to 50%. Then in step two, we need to look at liquid limit. If it's more than 50 or less than 50. And in step three, we use plasticity chart to see if it's silt or clay. So let's go over the steps again. Again, instead of the chart, you can use these slides. Step one, we look at percentage passing from number 200. And from here, the answer is no, more than 50%. So the percentage passing is higher or more than 50%. Then we say that we have a fine-grained soil. Next, in a step two, you need to look at liquid limit. If liquid limit is less than 50, liquid limit lower than 50%, then we have low plasticity, we use letter L. And if liquid limit is more than 50%, then we say we have high plasticity and we use letter H. This also summarizes the USCS classification for fine grain soil. We have fine grain soil. You look at liquid limit less than 50, more than 50. So less than 50%, more than 50%. Then you also need to answer if there is organic material observed or not. If the answer is yes, you directly go to OL or OH. Organic with high plasticity. Organic with low plasticity. But the answer is no, and we don't observe organic material, then you need to use plasticity charts. So here and here, you have to use plasticity charts. Now let's go over another example. Again, I give you 1 or 2 minutes. Just try to answer step one and step two. For step three, we need to use the plasticity chart, but you can provide the answer for step one and step two. Yes, so this is fine grain. Again, step one, we look at percentage passing from number 200. And percentage passing from number 200 is more than 50%. So now we know that we have fine grain material. 76%. So the answer is no. When we have fine grained soil, step two is to look at liquid limit. Liquid limit is provided 60%. Is liquid limit less than 50? No. Liquid limit more than 50% means that we have soil with high plasticity. Then we need to answer the question if we observed organic material or not. So the answer was no. So we have inorganic soil, which means that we either have silt with high plasticity or clay with high plasticity, which can also be referred to as elastic silt or fat clay. In order to answer this question, we need to use plasticity charts. So we have liquid limit 60, plastic limit 28. You calculate plasticity index as LL minus PL, which gives you 32, which is around here. So our point is above A line. This one is satisfied. And PI is higher than 7. So also, that one is also satisfied. We have CH or fat clay. Any questions? This is the complete plasticity chart with both A line and U line, but you don't need this one. I just wanted to show you, and you can also see the formula for A line. So if the point is very close to the line, you can use the formula of the line to see if it's above, below, or on the line. But again, you can see that this area we have MH or AH. In this area, it's either ML or LL, OL. Here, CH or OH, and here, CL or OL. And this is the hatched area or hatched zone, which is CLML. So just to go over what we talked today, first, step one, we look at percentage passing from sieve number 200 and determine if we have coarse material or fine. If we have coarse, then it's consisted of gravel and sand, but we need to see which one we have more. Then we also need to look at the percentage of fines if it's less than 5%, more than 12%, or between 5 to 12%. So well-graded gravel, which is a gravel-sand mixture with little to no fines. G-double. Poorly graded gravel, which is a gravel sand mixture, but mainly we have more gravel and it has very little or no fines. We also refer to when we have less than 5% fines, the material is referred to as clean gravel or clean sand. Means that the amount of fine is too low and we can ignore that. When we have fines more than 12%, then it's important enough for us to know if it's silt or clay. So we can have silty gravel, gravel, sand, silt mixture, which is GM, or clayey gravels, gravel, sand, clay mixture. Same thing for when we have sand. Then on the other hand, if from looking at percentage passing from number 200, we determine that we have fine grained soil, then we need to look at liquid limit, less than 50 or more than 50%. And then we need to look at plasticity chart to see if it's silt or clay. Inorganic silts, very fine sands, rock flour, silty or clayey fine sands of very low plasticity, ML, so liquid less than liquid limit less than 50 has low plasticity, liquid limit equal or higher than 50 has high plasticity. Inorganic clay of low to medium plasticity, CL, organic silt or organic silt clay of low plasticity, OL. Same thing for high plasticity. And if we have soil with high organic contents, then we just use PT, which means that it's peat and other highly organic soils. And this table is just for you to look at and see. We have different soil type with their symbols and which one has a better drainage, which type of soil works better with respect to workability, which one is suitable for subgrade, and which one is suitable for surface material. Well-graded materials and also coarse materials. So you remember we talked about this earlier. Coarser materials provide better drainage. When we have fine, especially when we have clay, there will be very low, poor drainage. So well-graded or poorly graded gravel, or even when we have sand, well-graded or poorly graded sand, when we have coarser material, we have a better drainage. When we have clay or silt, especially when we have clay, it will have a negative effect on drainage. Then when we have well-graded material, that's excellent for workability. They move along each other easier. They fill up the space between each other and provide higher strength. So well-graded sand and gravel are excellent with respect to workability. Then also you can check the results for application for subgrade and surface. This one is also for you to just look at the table. You don't need to memorize any of these numbers. But as you can expect, when we have larger particles, we have a stronger material. So coarse materials provide higher strength. And you can see that in this table too. So bedrock has the highest strength and highest allowable foundation pressure. Then we have sedimentary and foliated rock. Then we have sandy gravel or gravel, well graded or poorly graded. And with decrease in the size of the particles, you observe a decrease in allowable foundation pressure. So larger particles provide higher strength. That's where I'm gonna stop today. Do you have any questions?